God bless you. Share the video as you watch. Be blessed by the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus.
But I am saying, and Solomon had a voice of the Lord. And I said, where I am, send me. Jesus, here I am. Send me, Father. Send me. Repile anywhere. Jesus, I will go. And Solomon had a voice of the Lord. That's right. And I said, where I am, send me. This is not a breakthrough service. It is not a breakthrough service. It is a service for those who want the Lord to send them. It is a service for those who want the Lord to empower them. He said, you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost shall come upon you. It is a kind of service that those who want God to use them for his works. Solomon and a voice of the Lord. And I say, here I am, send me. It is a cry for revival. And Solomon had a voice of the Lord. And I say, here I am, send me. Abba Father, here I am. Jesus, send me. Anywhere. Solomon had a voice of the Lord. Repaya Kapaya. Here I am, send me. Yes. Ask him to send you. Father, I want to go for you. The Bible says he called his 70 and he sent them forth, two by two. Say, Father, use me to raise your name up, that men might be drawn to yourself. Say, Father, use me. Amen. Now, what is the Holy Ghost encounter? It's the baptism of the Holy Ghost and with fire. It is, if you look at the book of Matthew chapter 3, verse 11. Matthew 3, verse 11. John was talking to those that came to baptize. He said, I, John, indeed baptize you with water unto repentance. He said, but he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear. He said, he will baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. So, the Holy Ghost encounter is that baptism of the Holy Ghost, is that baptism of fire that Jesus has promised you and I. Number two, it is the promise of Jesus Christ made in John 14 verse 15 to 18. He said, I will not leave you comfortless. He said, I must go that the comforter might come. Number three, it is a cry for revival. Psalm 85 verse 6 says, will thou not revive us again, O Lord, that thy people might rejoice in thee. Which means there had been a revival before. But something happened and the revival died off. And the psalmist understood that the time and season he is in is a season where he needs to be revived. It's a season where he needs God to set him on fire. Number four. What is the Holy Ghost encounter? It is the outpouring of God's Spirit upon all flesh. Acts 2 from verse 17 to 18 says, in the last days, it shall come to pass in the last days, seeth God, not me. It shall come to pass in the last days, seeth God. Which means, it must come to pass. God is not a man that he should lie. Neither is he the son of man that he should repent. Has he said and shall he not do it? Or has he spoken and shall he not make it good? So whatever God says, shall put it up. Every tree in the life of anyone here that my heavenly Father has not planted, Father, by the reason of your word, let them be uprooted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's not your word like fire, said the Lord. It's not your word like hammer that breaketh the rock into pieces. Father, let the piercing power of the word of God, let the hammering power of the word of God, let the liquid fire of the word of God penetrate every heart here in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The word of God is quick, sharp, and powerful than two-edged sword. Piercing even to the joint of the marrow,
is a design of the thought and intent of the heart. Father, the word is sharper than two-edged sword. Father, let the authority in your word, the two sharp-edged sword of the living God, that pierces even to the joint of the marrow, that cuts asunder soul and spirit, Father, manifest in our midst tonight in the name of Jesus.